Everybody, Big Daddy here. So we are back in Monster Hunter World Iceborne, going up against the Black Dragon Fatalis with a very comfy greatsword build. Now, as you guys can see in the background, I don't currently have the build on me equipped because I'm going in there to use the ghillie mantle to load the cannons and stuff. So in just a second, you're going to see the build itself. So that those of you who are just looking for a solid build to go face him solo can go ahead and do so. However, I do still highly recommend that you watch the full video so that you can get all of the benefits of seeing me actually using this during the fight in different situations with him, going through each of the different phases, and we're going to be showing you guys the build right now. So first and foremost, as you guys can see, there are no Fatalis pieces in this build. So this is all things that you can create without actually having to face the dragon himself. So for this build, we have the Lightbreak Blade, the Brachydeum Helm Beta, the Elatrion Beta Chest, Arms, and Waist, and then the Call to Roth Beta Boots, as well as the Focus Charm so you can get to your True Charge faster, and using the Temporal and Rocksteady Mantles. So the TLDR for this fight is you want to use the Ballista and the One-Shot Binders to help you do damage to break his head, and then once you do break his head, at least for the first time, you essentially want to stand in his crotch to make your life easier. There are a couple of attacks that he has, which of course can hit you here, and he will focus some of those attacks, but for the most part, you just want to stay in between his legs with his chest weakened as much as possible. And just only go for the head on the situations where you're sure you have clear openings, like when he's doing a cone breath, or when you get the knockdowns on him with the Dragonator. But like I said, for the most part, the safest spot to play for Greatsword, because it is a very difficult build to use against him just because it's a heavy weapon, it sheaths slow, so if you can find spots in the build, if you feel like tweaking it to put, you know, 1 or 2 points of quick sheath, you may be able to get away with that, but you'll sacrifice a little bit of damage or survivability to make it easier on you, but it can be done. However, this is a build that I've tried and tested multiple times myself, and it has worked for me approximately 90% of the time, because you do get unlucky with things as far as him targeting you since you are solo, or missing your cannon shots or things like that. So this is still going to take a little bit of practice to be able to use, but like I said, it is a very safe build. It is going to allow you to tank some of his fireball shots without being one shot, as well as just in general making your life a lot easier with this fight. Now, this is still not a flawless run by any stretch of the imagination, but this is a very realistic scenario, so I do mess up in a couple places, which I'm sure you guys will see. However, I don't die at all in this fight. Like, I don't have any carts to my recollection. So even though I do mess up, you are still very easily able to survive a lot of his attacks and other things that he does to you. I will be going through and doing each of the 14 weapons with this fight. I've got a couple more sets ready to go, but I wanted to do this one first because I am a Greatsword main and I truly do enjoy this weapon, even though it is a hard weapon for this particular fight. So hopefully this video helps you guys out. Hopefully you enjoyed, and if you do, please make sure to like, comment, subscribe, ding the notification bell, and we will see you on the next one. Good luck out there, hunters.
Ugh.